My name is Adrian Mendiaz and I own Unique Stone, and this is my 2014 Cummins. I've owned this truck for about 3 years now. It's been a great truck, makes plenty of power, but when I towed, it felt like it was lacking a little power. So I took it to my buddies at ATS and they hooked me up with this emissions on turbo system, and I gotta tell you, it's amazing. I currently own 5 diesel trucks for my business. Most of them are deleted, but I did not want to go the same route with this truck. And this system is perfect. It looks stock, it's quiet, it makes plenty of power. And at the end of the day, I'm happy that I could tow whatever I have with this truck. This truck makes plenty of power. Right now it's doing about 600 horsepower. I jump on the truck, hook up a trailer, put the skid on there, feels like nothing at all. The original reason why I wanted more power is because I felt when I was towing, I was losing a lot of power. Now, when I tow, I feel a huge difference. So after my transmission went out, I decided to take it to my buddies at ATS. This truck is used to tow. It's used to plow snow. I use the shit out of it for everything. And I didn't want to have the same issue again. And I've had it now for about a month, and I'm getting used to the transmission. It's kind of stiff, but it feels really powerful. It doesn't slip. It's a great transmission. I never had to worry about the temperature. And so far, I've been extremely happy with it.
Hey crew, I'm Clint here with ATS Diesel, and today we're going to go ahead and do a baseline test on the Ram 6.7. So today we're going to go ahead and install the compound turbos and the twin fueler kit on this guy, and we're just releasing. Over the about the last 5 years of development, we finally got our compound turbo kit done, our twin fueler kit with the software. And you might ask yourself, why for the kind of power that these things are making today, you know, why do we really need compound turbos? Well, of course, everybody wants a little bit more power, but for pulling really heavy loads, I mean, the way these trucks are designed today, you know, they come out of the factory with somewhere around 350 to 370 horsepower. But what a lot of people don't really realize is because of all the controls on them, you know, the after treatment system and so everything's so tightly packed in there that they generate a lot of heat. And when you're pulling really heavy, say you have your fifth wheel in the back, your camper trailer, you know, your boat, your motorcycles, you know, a construction guy, you know, pulls a lot of weight. These things are really hot soaked, they get hot, you know. So when you're pulling in the real time, I mean, on the dyno, you know, we're gonna find out that factory power levels are in that, you know, 350 to 370 horsepower level stock. But the reality of it is when we really start pulling and you get this thing hot, that the engine begins to derate. It begins to actually take fuel out of the system because you don't have a lot of airflow. So the factory turbocharger is really limited based on the amount of airflow it makes. It's a pretty small inducer, really restrictive turbine housing, VGT. The nice thing about the factory turbos is they have an exhaust brake built in and they spool up quickly, but you get the sacrifice of not a lot of airflow up top. And airflow is exactly what you need to make higher power levels, and more importantly, is keep the engine cool. So as you start to heat saturate this thing with that little turbocharger, then at some point the engine has to sense that heat, and it starts to back fuel out of the engine so it doesn't melt the engine, and that equates to horsepower losses. So the reality of it is when you're pulling heavy loads, I mean, you're like really down to like 300 or maybe 280 horsepower real time when you're actually pulling these loads. And then when you slow down and you get some airflow again, then it starts to ramp the power back up. Well, we've developed a system where we add another turbocharger on top of the factory turbocharger. And that secondary turbocharger basically takes over when the factory turbo begins to run out of breath. So we have a big compressor that pulls air in from the atmosphere and it compresses it at a moderate rate and then shoves it into the factory turbocharger, and then the factory turbocharger compounds it, and that's where compounding comes from. Then you run through your intercooler and go to the engine. So the systems we have for all of the Dodge trucks now is full emissions on system. So you retain all of your EGR system, all of your urea, all of the after treatment, the DPF, the whole deal. So now we can get you up to that 650 horsepower range and have a totally legal, non-deleted, 100% clean diesel engine that is going to be very efficient, and you have more reliability because it takes the heat out. So we do it kind of in two ways. We add the secondary turbo, then we also add the twin fueler, which is a secondary injector pump. So it splits the load with this factory injector pump, and it basically makes it run at half power, which is the real advantage to it, is it relieves the factory high pressure pump, and it gives us the ability to maintain real pressure, which is atomization. And atomization means you're going to burn that fuel very clearly, and it's not going to have all the black smoke, which basically in a technical term means soot loading to the DPF. And when you soot load, or when you run all that black smoke into a diesel particulate filter, it clogs it up and it regens a lot. So we add the secondary injector pump to increase the efficiency of that fuel, to atomize it better. So when it goes in the after treatment system deals with it, doesn't have all the forced regens, and you don't have a huge economy decrease. So really the perfect combination between the compound turbos, adding our WAR 6000 to it, by adding the additional CP3, our twin fueler kit, and then optimizing the software, the program in the cab, then it gives you the ability to have not only full power, not derate, but power levels up in that 600 horsepower range, and you can use it every single day over the passes. So we're gonna go ahead and get a baseline on this guy right now, see where this baseline really comes in at for real time at 6,000 feet here in Denver, Colorado. And then once we do that, then we're gonna pull it over, we're gonna install the compounds, we're gonna install the twin fueler. So we're gonna let him go ahead and dyno this thing and see what we get. There we go, just like clockwork. 366 horsepower, 837 foot-pounds of torque. We're at 6,000 feet. That's a stock run, so that's nice and clean. That's pretty much what I would expect, you know, in a truck that's pretty heat saturated. You know, you'll see him run up to as high as about 380 on a really cold day at, you know, sea level. So I'd say we got a really good baseline. So we'll go ahead and run with this, the 366 horsepower, and then roll it over and do our compound turbo work and get the twin fueler on it, and then we'll roll it back over here and see what we get. So we just saw the truck run on stock configuration, and we're gonna go ahead and do our install for the compound turbo kit. Now this is the second turbo kit, and you kind of look under here, this is our factory turbocharger. It's on the truck existing. So we're gonna pull the pipe out that's underneath, which is this part. We're gonna pull this guy out and we're gonna replace it with this. So you see the similarities. So what's really cool about this kit is this Vortec manifold we've designed. The exhaust gas energy goes in here into this V, and then it channels in into the turbine housing, into this section, through the turbine housing, and then out the downpipe, which is this portion, goes out the downpipe and then into the aftertreat system. So this is literally all that's required to install your secondary turbos. You install this piece right on the back of your factory turbocharger. It mounts to the turbo and exhaust system. You add the second turbo, which is our WAR 6000, and then you have all the plumbing, the hardware, everything you need in this kit, super clean. Take out the fender well, add your compound elbow in, or the Vortex manifold, add the turbo, the intake, put in your heat blanket, which comes with every one of them, super clean. And then we also supply you a reservoir for your engine coolant, which is a nice billet piece that basically fits right here in the vehicle. And we redesigned that. Your factory one's a plastic unit that you know, isn't really robust. And one of the things that's interesting on the 13 Plus is they're running coolant pressures up at about 20 PSI, which is substantially higher than the older vehicles. So there's a lot of coolant pressure in these things. They do that so they withstand or sustain more heat in the water because it's under higher pressure. So, you know, we just took the extra time since we needed to redesign this, you know, build a nice billet one. It has your coolant sensor in, just plugs right in. So all of your factory controls, emissions, sensors, everything's intact. And it generally takes, with this system, about 4 hours to install it. Take out your fender well, plug the stuff in, put your coolant reservoir in, add it all done, and then you're pretty much good to go. So let's go ahead and get this thing installed. It's gonna take us a day. to do that, and then we're going to run it on the dyno afterwards and see what it does.
Hey, just want to talk to you a little bit about our twin fuel or CP3 system for the late model Dodge trucks. So what we do is we add a secondary CP3 system. This secondary CP3 basically splits the load of the fuel that's being injected to the motor, so you have a reliable system, so it doesn't stress the CP4. Your CP3 splits that, so it gives you the full volume you need. And mainly, it's more about the pressure that you want to maintain and maintain your fuel volume. So you get pressure and volume. The higher pressure maintains that you have good atomization. And then how do we control it? We have a nice little CP3 box here that plugs in the CP4, plugs in the CP3, creates its own demand, and it drives the pump. And then, of course, all our mounting bracketry is a nice little pump, the brackets, and all the quick disconnect parts. So these nice little quick disconnects allow everything just to plug in. So you open the box, put it on the vehicle, and you're done. Good look at numbers. So we just got a twin fueler on it and compound turbochargers and basic tow program. This is our emissions on program, of course, and we just rolled 597.7 horsepower, so about 580 horsepower and 1312 foot-pounds of torque. I like that torque number, that's impressive, and that's what you do all your towing with. So pretty much what you have here is, you know, we've got a pretty substantial increase over the factory turbocharger when we added our secondary charger. And this is a heat-soaked truck, so you're going to find that those are numbers, real-time numbers, that you can utilize when you're towing instead of it backing all the way down when the engine gets hot. With the secondary turbo, you know, we really maintain that airflow, so we keep the engine cool, which means we're turning fuel into power instead of turning into heat and overloading the after-treatment system. So those are really nice numbers. So this is pretty much what you get with like our basic tow program, emissions on program with both setups. If we didn't have the twin fueler on it, the numbers would be a little farther down. We wouldn't be able to pull it and push it as hard. But you'll also find if you want maximum numbers out of this thing, we can push this system to well over 650 horsepower when we start really fueling it up. But in this setup, it's a tow truck, you know, basically, you know, upgraded torque converter, have a co-pilot and a deep pan on it to keep the tranny alive, 68 RFE obviously, and then, you know, add the twin fueler, add the compounds, get that fueling, and he'll be able to pull his granite around. He's a granite contractor, and of course do his work on the weekends, which means pulling his big toy hauler around. So those are pretty much the numbers you can expect. The kit's available. You can go on our website, pick it up, or give one of our sales guys a call here at ATS Diesel for more information.